17, Romans number 5. The series that I've been dealing with is reigning in life. How to reign in life? Because God has said to us, God has said to us that the year 2016 is the year of our reign. God will cause us to reign. And so when a prophecy like that comes true, it is important that you understand the import of what God is saying. Because if you don't clearly understand what God is saying, you might not be in a disposition to obey God and to obey Him faithfully. Because God is not going to speak more than what He has spoken already. And every time God speaks to the people, it's a responsibility that God expects from that people, and that would be to obey. Say to us to obey. Talk to your neighbor, say to obey. So the book of Romans, chapter number 5, verse 17 says, "For if by one man offense, death reigned by one, much more the which received abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ." That's where we draw our topic from, reigning in life. And at the beginning of it all, I taught you and I showed to you the significance of the year 2016. And we deal with that a lot. But this morning, I was reading and preparing and praying about this very Sunday, because it's your last Sunday in the month of 2015. This is the last Sunday. You will not see this Sunday again, so you better make a good use of this Sunday. It's the last Sunday. Next Sunday you will see will be in the next year. And that may look exactly the same, but do not be, do not deceive yourself. There are no 2 days that are exactly the same. David said to God, "Teach me, oh Lord, how to number my days." And the problem with ours is that we seem to take every day just as the same. We feel that today is Monday. And the problem is that because you are doing exactly the same thing you used to do Monday to Friday, get to the same office, and you know, you have your lunch box, and you know that it's going to be a lunch by 12:30, and all of that, so you presume that every day is the same. But let me make it, you know, clear to you that there is no day that is exactly the same. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And the Bible says, "This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it." Every day that we have an opportunity, we should be able to rejoice. When we talk about this morning, I look at the word reign. I look at the word, the Bible says, "We shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ." And I try to, because, you know, sometimes there is a presumption that we understand the meaning of words. But, you know, when I look at the very Greek word that was used there, it's called basileo. Basileo means to be a king, to exercise kingly power, to reign. The one that catches, one of the meanings that catches my sight is to exercise the highest influence, to control. Tell somebody to exercise. Talk to your neighbor, say to exercise the highest influence. And so when God says that, you know, He intends you to reign, God has in mind that in whatever sphere of life that you are located, you will be able to exercise, you know, control, exercise influence. If it is in your teaching profession, you will become influential. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It means, basileo means to reign as a king, to exercise influence, highest influence. Somebody say, highest influence.
Highest influence.
And to control.
And
when I look at the Hebrew meaning of the same word is malak. Malak means to be, you know, to be clothed with royalty. So God is saying that I'm going to give you opportunity to exercise your highest influence and be clothed in royalty. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I talked to your neighbor, say, I will be clothed in royalty.
I will be clothed.
Or say it like you mean it. I will be clothed in royalty. There's a law of first mention in the Bible. I talk to you about this all the time. That every time a word is mentioned in the Bible, to be able to understand the true meaning of what the import of that word is, you have to find it in the first time it was ever mentioned in the Bible. You have to find out where the word was mentioned in the Bible to understand the entire cause of that word. Now, when I try to find out the place that the word was mentioned, it is found in the book of Genesis chapter number 37. And the book of Genesis 37 is an interesting book because it has to do with one man that was called Joseph. Hallelujah. Now let's open to our Bibles to Genesis chapter number 37, and I want to have the privilege to read with you from verses 3 to about verse 11. Then we will be able to encounter the word rain so that it will make some sense what God is trying to say to you today and for the year that has come, so that you will be in a position to fulfill this prophecy. The Bible says in the book of Genesis, chapter number 37, now Israel there is talking about Jacob. Jacob loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age, and he made him a coat of many colors. Now, what would we hear? And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peacefully or peaceably unto him. Look at verse 5. And Joseph dreamed a dream. Somebody said, Joseph, dream a dream.
Joseph dream.
Say again, Joseph, dream a dream. Somebody about your dream, you will not celebrate it. I don't know who I'm speaking to this morning. So we tend to hide our dreams. But the Bible said Joseph dreamed a dream, and even though he was already hated by his brethren, he talked to them about his dream. Tell somebody, you're going to talk to somebody about your dream. I'm saying, you have to be bold about your dream, because the reason that many of us are not succeeding is that we are not bold about our dreams. We are scared to dream, and even when we dream, we are not bold to talk to people about our dreams, because sometimes when you talk to folks about your dreams, they laugh at you. Sometimes when you talk to people about your dreams, you know, they mock you. They make you a laughing stock. They don't. They look at you and they say, "So you too? You too?" You, they say you have big eyes. You like high things. Because you're just talking to them about your dreams. Hallelujah. The Bible said Joseph dreamed a dream, and he talked to his brethren about his dreams. And he said unto them, "Hear, I pray you, this dream which I dream. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheep arose, and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaves stood about and made obeisance to my I wish I had somebody here. Now Joseph told them the dream." Somebody said Joseph told them the dream. I know that you are afraid to tell somebody where you are going in life. You're not bold enough to tell somebody where you are going in life because they're going to laugh at you. The Bible says Joseph told them the dream, and he said to them, "I dreamed, and we were all gathered gathering sheets. Let me use the word firewood, which may be a little bit understandable to us. He said, we were gathering firewood, and I had a bundle, and we all had a bundle. But look at what happened. All your bundles, they bowed to my own bundle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell somebody, I am about to reign. I didn't hear you. Tell somebody, I'm about to reign. So you better be comfortable with me, because where you see me now, it's not where you're going to see me next year. I don't understand what I'm saying. So don't feel uncomfortable. Okay, let me use the right word. Tell somebody, don't be jealous. Because things are about to change.
I'm about to get married again. I'm about
I have a dream. and dream. It's just like the first dream that I had. This time around, it is not the sheep, it is the sun. It is the moon. And it is the stars. Bow down to my star. The sun is about to bow down. The moon is about to bow down to your own. Before it was the brothers, now your entire household is about to recognize. Your household is about to recognize the grace of God that is upon you. You have been going through things because of the grace of God. Some of you don't know that life has become so tough to you because you have been assigned to be a king. Some of you are going through difficulties because you have been disposed and created to be a king. And that's why you're suffering what you're suffering. You're thinking about everyone is not going through what I go through. Because everyone is not about to reign. So when they thought that they have finished with these dreams, when they thought by their hatred they have quelled it on the inside, he came by and said, I have another dream. Tell somebody, I have another dream. And they said, well, what about the one you dreamed in 2015? Say, forget, I have another dream. It looks like it did not succeed in 2015. Say, I have another dream. I am a dreamer. I wish I had some folks who know how to dream. If the first dream did not come to pass, you dream another dream. You have another dream. Joseph said, if that one was not okay, I have another dream. And they said, that was last year you told us. So forget about last year. 2016, I have another dream. Because you don't want to stop me from dreaming. Because one thing I know, my dream shall come to pass. Somebody shout hallelujah. They said, what about the dream of last year? He said, I have another dream. I have another dream. This one is bigger than that one of last year. The sun and the moon and the stars, they are about to bow down. The reason that dream did not come to pass was because it was not big enough. It was a small dream. Now it is the one that is going to move the sun, the moon, and the stars. Your dream is about to impact not only your family, but the entire nation. I wish I'm talking to somebody. Hallelujah. So he said, I have another dream. And watch here with me. And they said, what is this dream thou hast dreamed? Tell somebody, what is the dream? I have another dream. He said, what is this dream that you have dreamed? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he said, behold, I dream. I dream more. And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars still made obeisance to me. And he told it to his father and to his brethren. And his father said, keep short, man. You drink too much. First reality. Have I saw somebody told you like that? You drink too much. First reality. Did you read the newspaper today? First reality, do you know how much is a dollar to the rand? First reality, tell them I have another dream. He says, shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come and bow ourselves to thee, to the earth? Is it true? The father asked him, do you understand this kind of dream that you're having? That you are going to become a financial pillar of the family. That everybody in the family will have to look up to you. I don't know who I'm talking to. time this dream that you are about to be so much control, so much influence that the entire family will have to listen to you. You are a small boy. Tell somebody,
I have a dream
that is going to change things. Hallelujah. Look at the person straight into the eyes and say, I have a dream. Say, is it possible?
Yes.
That was the problem. Say, it's possible. We will come around you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But Joseph had a dream. And you know what that dream entails. The Bible said because of the dream, they put him in a pit. They tried to stop the dream. Many of you have been in the pit for too long, but you are about to come out. The enemy has put you in the pit. Some of you are suffering things that you don't have answers. It looks like God is not answering your prayers. There are things in your life that are inexplicable. It cannot be explained. You don't understand it. Let me tell you that Joseph did not understand why the brothers should put him in the pit. He did not understand why he should be sold as a slave. But there was something that he understood. He had a dream. It doesn't matter what you are going through. I came to tell somebody, hold on to your dream. And they put you in the pit. Hold on to your dream. They may sack you from the job. Hold on to your dream. They may disaliate you from the family. Hold on to your dream. Tell somebody, hold on to your dream. And the way, let me tell you what the Lord told me. He says, some of you, the reason why you have been stagnated for so long is because you are afraid of the very thing that stopped you. Some of you have washed your hands out of. Some of you will never get to a relationship anymore because of the past experience. You are so afraid because you've got your fingers burnt in it that you don't want to go back there again. But I came to tell somebody that the very thing that got you burned, the very thing that got you wounded, the very thing that got you set back, disappointed, cried, and torn up is the same thing that God wants you to roll over. That's a problem with us. We have become too cautious of what mistakes and what failures in our lives. We're trading cautiously. Relationship, that's not for me.
Yes, Lord.
A business, I am just good with this job, you know. I'm sure of the slide. Business is dicey. Because the first time you get into business, you lose a lot. Because you lose it was the reason why you lost it is because that's where you're supposed to win. Are you living better?
Yes.
You don't lose. Except in the place you were expecting to win. And if you didn't expect to win, you would not have been there. If you didn't have a dream, you would not have been into business. You would not have been into relationships. You would not have been working in that particular area where you are. Because you had a dream. But you got your fingers burnt. And you retracted yourself. Said, that one is not for me. But God said, I must call up the Josephs. I must call unto Joseph, who had a dream and he was thrown into the pit, who had a dream and was sold as a slave back into Potiphar's house. And because of the dream, he was deceived, manipulated, lied upon. Injustice prevailed. Some of you are suffering injustice.
Yes, Lord.
Some of you are suffering from injustice. You have been wrongly accused, wrongly abused, wrongly used by every other person. And you're wondering, I am trying to be good and nobody's seeing it. I am trying my best. You know, it is because of the dream. Tell somebody, it's because of the dream. It's because of the dream. You have been so alienated. You don't want to take any risk again. You're just cautious about life. You're walking very cautious. You don't want to, those are no good areas. God said, I should tell you, the areas that you dread the more is where your success lies.
Amen.
Are you ready? The place that you feel most, that's where your treasure is. The Bible said, while Joseph was put in the pit, while he was sold as a slave, when he was suffering and wrongly accused and put in jail, he still drew dreams. Because the Bible said the butler and the baker from the Pharaoh's palace, they had a dream. While he was yet in prison, let me tell you that if I was Joseph, I am in prison in a foreign land without doing anything, just anything to do with it. But thank God for Joseph. He is a man of a dream. Wherever there is dreaming, he put himself. And so the Bible said, when the butler and the baker had a dream, they came to Joseph. I said to Joseph, I know you are a man of dreams. What is the meaning of the dream? Joseph said, okay, I will tell you. Your dreams.
Amen.
The area of your life that you most dread is where your blessing is. The area of your life where you so much dread to go into, where you've been so hurt, where you're feeling so much of pain, when people mention it, say, cut me out, I'm not into that anymore. That's the area where your blessing is. That's because you had a dream before. You just been attacked because of the dream. You just been hated because of the dream. They abuse you and used you because of the dream. So now you are cautious. You are dreaming cautiously because of your dream. And you don't want to go to those areas again. But thank God for Joseph. When they said they had a dream, he still do dreams. Tell somebody, I still do dreams. I still do dreams. No matter how many times I've been hurt, no matter how many times I feel disappointed, I still do dreams. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Bible said, for once more in his life, he attended to dreams. He interpreted the dreams of the butler and the baker. And the Bible said, in the space of 2 years, another person had a dream. I know you have been involved with the butler and the baker all your life, and you thought that your dream is not taking you anywhere because you are just stuck in that establishment. You don't know that a Pharaoh is about to have a dream. Tell somebody, stop dealing with dreams. Somebody is about to have a dream. So don't stop that business because it is about to be a breakthrough. Don't stop in the failure of that past relationship. Because don't stop where you have failed. Don't stop where they have hurt you. Don't stop where there is pain. Move on. Tell somebody, move beyond your pain. Let me talk to your neighbor. Say, move beyond your pain. Move beyond your tears. you. Get out of it. Get out of it. Move out of the season of pain. Move out of the season of sorrow. Move out of the season of crying over and asking God why. And move to the next season. Because the next season is the season of your promotion. It's a season of your promotion. Tell somebody, get out of the bed. Oh, come on, get out of the bed.
Forget about who's calling your name. You have a future. You have a dream. righteous man will fall 7 times, but the Lord, I will pick it up. You have not fallen 7 times. It's just 1 time, and you are still sitting down crying, crying about who did what, crying about what family did.
Was still dealing with dreams. Oh Lord, he dreamed, and nobody could deal with his dream. But he was dealing with other people's dreams. Hallelujah. I tell somebody, do not stop to do good. Do not stop what you have been doing. Do not let situations change you. Do not let circumstances change you. Do not let people change you. Do what you have been doing. Be faithful in what you have been doing. Trust the Lord. For the Bible said, a little shall become a thousand, and a thousand shall become a great nation. I don't know who I'm speaking to this morning. You have been doing it, and it looks like there is no change. You have been faithful, and it looks like nothing has been happening. But I come to prophesy to somebody, you have just entered a season of your harvest. You are about to harvest all your labor of love. You are about to harvest. Your fasting is about to come true. Your prayers is about to be answered. Your desires of your heart are about to manifest. Do not stop. Do not stop. Sometimes we feel like we want to give up. Feel like we want to give up and say no. But Joseph, he still dreamed. He still had his own dream. He interpreted the dream of the butler. He interpreted the dream of the baker. They all entered into the fasting. Tell somebody, do not be jealous. I brought him or her to church, but things are better with her than me. Forget about it. I was here in this church before everyone else, and my stuff is not working out. Forget about it. Your labor of love is about to yield result. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Bible said that Pharaoh had a dream. Hallelujah. If you don't stop doing dreams, somebody is about to have a dream. Hallelujah. A dream that will interpret your dream and change your life. Hallelujah. You don't know that you have access to people's dreams. You are an answer to people's problems. The thing is that you are so engulfed with yourself that you cannot see any other person else. You are so self-entwined that you are not thinking about, you don't understand that your life is going to unlock other people's dreams. As long as you are into yourself, you are not going to be able to make it, because other people's dreams are interwoven in your dream. While your dream has been delayed, it's because other people's dream is part of your dream. Why your dream has been delayed. It wasn't a denial. It was because your dream is bigger than yourself. And what God is about to use you to do is bigger than yourself. You've been thinking within yourself. Why you have not had money? It's because money that you're about to have is more only for your family. Money that you're about to have is about to change society. It's about to change other people's life. That's why money has been delayed from you. It's not because God has denied you money, because other people are part of your dream. And what Joseph did not understand was that while he was being put into prison, while he was
suffering as a slave was that he needed to learn the pious protocol, because his dream was not a dream for his father's house. His dream was a national dream. He had to be trained. He had to be prepared to take the center stage. And that's why he went to prison. That's why he served in Potiphar's house, to learn the command, to learn how to walk majestically in the palace. Because before he was walking like this, but now he had learned that as a king, you have to walk in majesty. So that was just a learning curve. Somebody was just a learning curve. He was just learning. He did not understand. But the Bible says, when Pharaoh had a dream, nobody could interpret it. There's a dream that only you have the key. Are you hearing me? There's a dream that only you have the interpretation. And you don't know. You are doing pity party. You are thinking about yourself. You don't know that the dream that you have, it's not for you. It is a national dream. The money that is about to come for you is not the money for, you know, I just made a house and 3 minutes, 3 square meters. It's not that kind of money. If it's that kind of money, God would have given you sins. But the money you're about to have is the one that will feed your whole strength. You will transform your society. You will transform your neighborhood. When there is a demand, you will see the sick and you will take them. You will not feel any pain. You will walk in the school and say, young girl, why are you not in school? If the boy said, Mama, I said, don't worry, come to school. Because that's where the money is coming from. You will not feel nothing. You've been thinking all about yourself. That's why your dream is in the lane. Because you're thinking, I'm just looking for 3 square meals. If I have a 2-bedroom house, even too much for me. Not even if it's 1 bedroom, it's fine. I just need 1 car. No, you don't need a car. You need a factory. Enough is enough of praying for a car. It's time to pray to own car manufacturing things. Because when you own car factories, you don't have to pay to drive. You just say, bring that one for me. And you move. Only for Mercedes Benz. I can just get 1 Mercedes Benz. It's okay. You know, I'm not greedy. God didn't say you're greedy. There are other people. You just need a car. How are you going to help other people go to church who don't have cars? How are you going to say, well, I have asked my taxis to pick everybody in the locations around the church. They don't have to pay. Church, you don't have to. I just need a car. And God said, no, I am not interested in a car. I need cars. Because there are thousands of one people that need to ride. And they cannot. And you just need a solution to that. Just say, where are you guys going? I'm going out. My driver will take you. You saw the neighbor with a sick baby. And they're standing. And they need to go. You are late to business. You cannot go. Say, where are you going? I need to go to the hospital. Say, don't worry. You take the phone. Hello, driver. There's a lady standing by the bus stop. He's going to take her to the hospital. Make sure that he takes care of the bills. Have you not heard the Samaritan? But he paid for the man who fell among the thieves. He paid for the hospital bill and left extra food. How are you going to solve problems? How are you going to demonstrate the love of God with 50 rand in your pocket? With, you know, 100,000 in your pocket? That is not even enough for you. Didn't God want to make you a millionaire so that you can have food? You already have food. You can, no matter how much you have, you won't eat beyond what you're already eating now. I promise you. How many of you ever get to the buffet very hungry?
Yes, Lord.
And they say it's 120. He said, I'm going to do justice.
Only after two times you'll be looking at the plate. You'll be looking at the food. The food is still lying. When people are coming to eat, you'll be looking. How many people in the buffet? And you just got two rams. And you were very hungry. And the rest time you're sitting there looking. The next thing, you don't like fruit, you begin to take fruit. You eat meat. If you're like me, I start with meat, I start with fish, I eat. By the time I go sit down, I don't know who. And smiling at everybody, it's cool already. Those people that have it, you cannot eat no matter how hungry, you cannot eat beyond your capacity. Yeah. So they don't worry, they say, pay 120, enter. You enter, I'm going to shut you people. You're going to shut yourself. Because by the time you take, you know, if you're wise, you won't even go near pap and rice. You just go to the different kind of beef and all the slices of meat, and you take them. Let him see that. But if you succeed to finish that one, the next one you're looking, you can't do anything.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. I'm about to close here. Watch this. The Bible says that Joseph had a dream. And his dream was interwoven in another dream. A dream of Pharaoh. Not until Pharaoh dreamed, your dream will not be interpreted.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So it's not just somebody delay, it's not denial.
It's not delay.
That you did not get it in 2015 does not mean that God denied you. It does not mean that God did not hear your prayer. It did not mean that you did not pray right. It's because your dream is waiting for Pharaoh.
Yes,
there's a Pharaoh that must have a dream. And when Pharaoh had a dream, the Bible said no other person could interpret the dream. Look at the book of Genesis. I'm about to close here. I couldn't even go further than part one. Genesis chapter 41. And the Bible said that, you know, Pharaoh had a dream. And all the magicians and all the wise men and all the astrologers, nobody could interpret the dream of Pharaoh. Except one man who was in prison. Where you have been with God, nobody has been there. You don't understand. Where you have been with God, nobody has been there. Nobody was there in the time of tears. Look at verse 14. Let me start from verse 14. Hallelujah. Verse 14. Hallelujah. Then Pharaoh sent and called Joseph, and they brought him hastily out of the dungeon, and shaved him, and changed his raiment, and came into, to Pharaoh. Somebody say, I'm about to be taken with haste.
I'm about to be taken with haste.
Into my destiny.
Into my destiny.
God is about to catapult me. Into my blessings. See, there have been a delay. There have been, a setback. There have been disappointment. But 2016 is a year that you're going to run faster than you ever run. You're going to run faster than you ever run in your life. Things are going to happen in such a space that some of you will be calling pastor. This time it's not because of demons. Pastor, please pray for me. They are promoting me twice in a year. I don't know. Your call is not going to be to bind the devil anymore. Your call is not going to be. When you call me at midnight, you say, Pastor, I just got double promotion. I didn't even finish with the next one. Pastor, please pray for me. I need wisdom for the next position. Yes, it was for the heads. Was fast. He has been waiting. See, you are about to cover every distance you miss. In the race of life, you are about to cover every distance that you miss. People that have been ahead of you will find you in front. People that have been driving, Toyota, they will will see you with MM. See you in front, because the Bible says you shall be the head and not the tail. But it looks like you've been in the tail. It looks like that word of God is not being fulfilled. It's about to fulfill today.
Amen.
You will be ahead and not the tail. Ahead of your enemies. Ahead of your directors. Ahead in your company. Ahead in your business. They say, when did you start? Absalom will be calling you. He said, how? You're banking too much. You're banking too much. Can you come and see the manager? They need to talk to you. How many of you know that if you have a certain amount of money, the bank begin to talk to you? They invite you for dinner. The reason that you don't know that the dinner is in the bank is because you're only banking 5,000. There are people that ask and invite for dinner. How many of you know that?
Let
me be my the banks. At the end of the year, the bank invite them for a dinner. And you've been going there. Put my name. And they say, ATM, take the card. They don't invite you. There are people who don't come to bank. You wonder how some people get into the bank and go so fast while you're still in the camp. Because they have called for the money in the house. There's what is called call account. You don't go and give. You call from your house. I need 600,000 to be ready. I'll pick it up at 11 o'clock. And the manager said, yes sir. Please come by 11:30. And the man walking. And you are still cute. I don't know why these people. They are no cashier. You still complaining about no cashier. In the camp, they only took cashier. They don't even know that it's the end of the month. There are people here. You still complaining. Other people are trying. Tell somebody, that's how to rain. Somebody walk in and take the money out. Why are you still complaining? This cashier, I don't know what. Look at that one. He's going for lunch now. Don't you see us? How many of you ever complained about the cashier? There are some people that don't know cashiers. They just call from the house and the money is ready. If they just send them and they walk in and the manager said, please come in. And they said, you thought that they are discussing. He came to withdraw. He's already gone. And you're fighting with the cashier. Look at that one. He's going to lunch now with all of us of the kids leaving us. Stop complaining about cashier. Tell somebody, rain. Exercise influence and control. Hallelujah. I don't like those cashiers when you go in and they leave for lunch. How many of you have never stayed in there? Why do you keep them waiting for lunch? Tea time.
Tea time.
I want to go somewhere. I want to withdraw this 2,000. You were suffering to withdraw 2,000. There are people withdrawing 2 million. They don't suffer. They call from the house. Hallelujah. I'm about to close it. Let's go to verse 41. Listen, the Bible says, with a curse, they took him out of dungeon. God is about to take you ahead of every person that has gone ahead of you. Hallelujah. God is about to take your hand. Look at verse 41. Hallelujah. Verse 41. Jesus. Verse 41. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, see, does he not see?
See.
I have set you over all the land of Egypt. He's coming from prison. They shaved him so fast. They changed his clothes so fast. And he appeared before Pharaoh. And the only thing he was told is that I have set you over the land. Look at this. And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it upon Joseph's hand. And arrayed him in the vestures of fine linen and put a gold chain about his neck. And he made him to ride in the second chariot which he had. And they cried before him, bow thy knee. They are bound to bow before him. Are you believing in it? Those who has mocked you, they are about to bow before you. Are you doing the God that you say? You don't know the God that you say.
Shouting. The Bible says where the word of the king is, there is power.
Kings don't shout. Kings don't shout. Just think of it.
I was.
The king said, what did he say? Hello, who could be? Yes. Yeah, I was to celebrate. He just said, who could be? He didn't ask you to come. There is no meaning to who could be. But you know, who could be? No, you don't talk like that. You just ask, who could be? And people are coming. Yes. Who could be means, where are you? You didn't tell them to come, but when you ask, they know what it means that you're looking for them. Now, who could be? Come. What's the matter? What is the time now? Where are you? You won't be shouting. Just say, who could be? And the people are surrounding you. Come. It's your time to reign. Hallelujah. Stand on your feet. Malabasa takabasa. Rakabosita. Rekidabos. It's your time to reign. Makabasa. He said, and Pharaoh said, pull out that scripture. He said, nobody will lift up his head. We lift up his feet in this land, except you have said so. God is about to lift you up. God is about to take you from the position of mediocrity to the position of recognition. Hallelujah. Rabba Shatta Rabba Shatta Yabba. Rikabo Shatta Yabba. Marabra Shatta Rabba Shatta Yabba.
Lift up your hands up. Stand before him.